الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله فقد غوى نسأل الله ربنا يجعلنا ممن يطيعه ويطيع رسوله ويتبع رضوانه واجتنب سخطه فإنما نحن به وله. To proceed, the best discourse is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the best example is the example of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst practice in the Islam is the introduction of the new element in the faith. Each of them is a bud'ah. Each bud'ah lead to the hellfire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from following each of these bid'ah. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Amma ba'd. Today I would like to talk about subject that is the topic going on these days about Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, Al-Quds Al-Sharif. Once a person went to his house shouting, crying for his wife. She didn't understand, but she calmed him down and asked him the following question. And he's, while he's getting to the house, and he say, wa musibata, wa musibata. An Arabic word to say, oh, a disaster happened. So she tried to calm him down, and I want you to pay attention how clever this lady was. She told him, which disaster are you talking about? Has the enemy of Islam attacked us? He said, no. He said, have they killed Amir al-Mu'mineen? He said, no. She asked him, have the enemy captured one of our holy sites? He said, no. She told him, there is no disaster. Because all other things is dunya matter, worldly matter, and everything. وَكُلَّ مَا فَوْقَ التُّرَابِ تُرَابُ And this is a wise lady. Teach us now. What's happening to us? If we ask ourselves, in hands of whom Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa? What's happening to Iraq and Syria and Yemen and so many other Muslims in the rest of the world? Which tell you really, we are not in good position. قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِي أَنفُسِكُمْ This is because of your hand. إِنْ تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرْكُمْ How we give victory to Allah? By obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by following his order and following Sunnah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A typical question we ask ourselves, do you love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? 100% they say, of course, yes. Then tell him, okay, show me in practice how much you're following the order of Allah and the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We all might feel ashamed of ourselves. Having said that, for this introduction, the question is, why Masjid al-Aqsa is important? It's just a mosque. It's just in a land where, mashallah, so many mosques. I mean, if you go to see all these pictures of mosques in construction, wow, compared to Masjid al-Aqsa. So So why we are bothered about it? Why we as Muslim, not Arabic, not Palestinian, not Arabic, as Muslim, we have to pay special attention to this important place that Allah decided to him. They asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the first masjid mosque was built? He said, the Masjid al-Haram. And they say, what's next? He said, al-Masjid al-Aqsa. They ask him, how many years? There's 40 years between them. Then, we know al-Masajid is Buyut Allah, the house of Allah. Then Allah ordered to build this masjid. So ask yourself, would that masjid will be unimportant because Allah ordered to build it or no? If we talk about this masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he never mentioned it unless it's the blessed land. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا أنه السميع البصير. Glory to Allah who did take his servant Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم for a journey by night from the sacred mosque Mecca to the farthest mosque المسجد الأقصى القدس whose around we did bless. So pay attention, الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهُ. So the whole area is blessed, not only that spot. And just to tell you how important the whole area is for the Muslim by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because the Palestinian wish this, or the Arabic wish, or you the Muslim want. It's order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What else? Only for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? No, brothers and sisters. قال موسى يا قوم ادخلوا الأرض المقدسة التي كتب الله لكم. In المائدة Moses is talking his people, oh my people, enter the sacred land. الأرض المقدسة. Didn't say the spot, the whole land. What else? سليمان عليه السلام ولسليمان الريح عاصفة تجري بأمره إلى الأرض التي باركنا فيها. In Surah Al-Anbiya, and to Sulaiman we did subjected the wind, blowing strongly, pursuing its course at his command to the land we had blessed. And I just want you to give you this example from Al-Quran to tell you why this land is important. Because we see a lot of demonstration. I'm sure we go to the news today, you see demonstration all over the world. But if we ask each of you, or let us ask myself, do we understand why it's important? Do we need to pay extra attention to it, at least in dua? That is the subject of today in order to understand why it's important. Even they say, some of the tafsir, they say that is the blowing of the end of this life would be in Masjid al-Aqsa. واستمع يوم ينادي المنادي من مكان قريب. Surah Qaf. And then Qurtubi and others, scholars, they say it is referred to this land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين. والتين والزيتون, teen figs, زيتون referred to the land full of blessing, delicious food, blessed soil, referred to al-masjid or that area, what is called Palestine. وطور سينين, the mountain in Sina, والبلد الأمين, referred to Mecca al-Mukarrama. And that's why it's so important to us. This land is blessed. This land, Allah ordered to build the house for it, and that's why it's important. But why to us? Why to the Muslim? Again, we must understand the reason behind that correctly. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I mean, first of the fact, as you know, big part of the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Qibla was the Masjid al-Aqsa. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when mentioned it, he always sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it with al-Masjid al-Haram and al-Masjid al-Aqsa, al-Masjid al-Nabawi. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إنما تضرب أكباد المطيء إلى ثلاثة مساجد المسجد الحرام ومسجدي هذا والمسجد الأقصى. There's three places that you should make effort to go and visit them. المسجد الحرام مكة المكرمة مسجدي هذا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رفير المسجد النبوي المدينة المنورة آن المسجد الأقصى القدس الشريف. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Salatun, or the meaning of what he said, praying in my mosque equivalent. So you pray one pray, the reward you get it as you praying 1,000 salat. And if you pray in Masjid al-Haram, equivalent to 100,000 salat. And in Masjid al-Aqsa, when you pray there once, equivalent the reward to a 500 salat. And why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam associated Masjid al-Aqsa to Masjid Nabawi, Masjid al-Haram? In order for we follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to pay attention to it. The question is, do we pay attention as it should be? Do we understand the reason behind it? We have to make the effort in order to understand this reason, brothers. Not only by going out and shouting, and hoping from that president or that president make something, is we have to do the things. Again, let us ask the same question. So what? Allah ordered to build? Build. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a hadith, okay, join pray and that's it. But why you, Muslim, have to be responsible on it? Why not somebody else? They have better management, they have better money, better technology. Why we have to be responsible on this blessed land? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The religion before Allah is Islam. Okay, but then the other prophets, they were there. Ibrahim and Ishaq and Yusuf and so on and so forth. Yaqub mean Abdullah, which is the name of Israel. He was there because Allah, the religion for Allah is Islam. And all the prophets are Muslim by submitting their will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, between Adam and Nuh, 10 centuries, all of them lived according to Islam. What's the proof? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَمَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا. Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father of all the prophets, as we say. He was Jewish? No. Christian? No. He was Muslim. Ibrahim was neither a Jew nor a Christian, but he was truly a Muslim. And Al-Imran, then, okay, he was Muslim, and so what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, إِنَّ أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِإِبْرَاهِيمَ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُ وَهَذَا النَّبِيِّ, refer to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاللَّهُ وَلِيِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Most surely the people who are nearest to Ibrahim are those who followed him. And this Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who else? And those who believe in him. Allah is the guardian of the believer. So why we do not carry the Muslim? No, all the Prophet carry the same message. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And Ibrahim enjoyed upon his son, and so did Jacob. Oh, my son, Allah has chosen the faith for you. Then die not except in the state of Muslim by submitting your will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the exact message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all mankind through all the prophets. Be a Muslim. فسيدنا يوسف توفني مسلما والحقني بالصالحين. يوسف عليه السلام يك دعاته الله سبحانه وتعالى Let me die as a Muslim and unite me with the righteous. Do we understand, brothers and sisters, why the Muslim, not Palestinian, not Arabic, we are Muslim, the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We must pay attention to this land and understand why it's important. And eventually it will be for the Muslim sooner or later. And we're going to prove the evidence of that. There is so many hadith about that. The time is very short. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي لكم. ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. What we have to do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمْ لَا لُونَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Do not lose hope. Do not be sad. You will be the winner with one condition. He did not say, if you are Muslim, إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ, if you are faithful, that you believe and apply in your life upon whatever you believe, whatever the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the teaching of Allah, of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in الصفات, وَلَقَدْ سَبَقَتْ كَلِمَتَنَا لِعِبَادِنَا الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. We need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, our word has already gone out. Listen, has already gone out. Not is going to come. It's already been written. It's already gone out over servant messenger. It is they who will be supported. And our troop will be the victors. All what we need to do, brothers and sisters, is educate ourselves better, enhance our faith, apply our faith in our life, and everything will be exactly of Allah want, that peace will be in this land, inshallah. Inni da'if aminu. Allahumma laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhik wa al-azim sultanak ya rabb al-alamin. اللهم اجعل المسلمين يهتمون بالمسجد الأقصى. اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى وثبت المجاهدين في المسجد الأقصى ومن يعاونهم ومن يدعو لهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اخزي أعداء المسلمين ومن والاهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم نسألك عيشة السعداء وموتة الشهداء وصاحبة الأنبياء. وسبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.